Hello, this is Andy Ace 83, and today we are going to do another haul. I got this package today, and I got my paper knife, and we are ready to do some chopping and opening. The last one I did, we got this cup. One moment, this one. I'm drinking coffee from it right now. And today we are going to open this one. I wonder what it could be. I buy a lot of stuff online. I really do. But this, as I've already stated, I got this one for free. That's the point of it. By answering all of these questionnaires about what kind of stores I buy stuff in, what kind of companies I've heard of, just basic commercial questions. And I got a note stating that they are very glad for my contributions to the questionnaire thing, and I hope I will appreciate the gift. And here's the gift. Let's have a look. Whatever could it be? A Moomin cup! Whee! Isn't that pretty? Isn't that great? Huh? Look! That guy, I don't know what's his name in English, but in Norwegian we call him Snusmumriken. And a guy on the internet uses that as his avatar. And that guy is a pervert. He eats from the dumpster. That's the true story. He calls himself Fortelleren, which means English the narrator. And he's like this green guy. So he uses that avatar, and then he explains on Twitter that he's eating out of dumpsters. Oh, I found some good bread in the dumpster today. There have always been people like that, though. He hides himself behind you know, climate change, green. But there's always been town originals who's eaten out of dumpsters. Because, for instance, there are many town originals who are very cheap. You know, they are like, oh, I need to save my money. So they will eat out of dumpsters to save money. Yeah, there are many stories I've heard about town originals who die millionaires, right? And mind you, they usually die childless, you know. So everything they saved up just goes to the government every time, like, yay. They don't have, like, usually they don't have any family at all, like, whatever parents they had were dead, and siblings, they don't even know who they are, and no children, like, because they're town originals, so they can't repop, they don't have family. And so they say up all these things, like, and there's greed. I mean, you could say, like, why am I making fun of town originals? Because it's like a neurotic greed, and it's kind of disturbing. Like, it's like a, kind of like hoarding. It's kind of like rat mentality. And this guy, as I said, the Fortelleren, is one of those guys. But he hides behind climate change. But really, he's just a perverted, horrible human being. They are very rich when they die. Because they're like, they haven't been working because they're too destroyed in their head to do that. But they have been very cheap, probably eating out of dumpsters. And then they have like, how should I put it? Say the, in Norway we have, you can pick up bottles and you get money. If you pick up bottles, you get a krona or 2 kronas for each bottle, and then they will go around picking up the litter to try to sell it in the store. So it's probably like one of those guys, but he says he just does it for the climate, but he's really just a perverted, horrible human being who eats out of dumpsters. And he uses that one as an avatar, and he's called Snusmøvrik in Norwegian. But that character doesn't eat out of dumpsters. I mean, he's in contact with nature and all those things, right? I'll ask my girlfriend, isn't that true? Snusmøvriken, yes, Snusmøvriken is in contact with nature and stuff like that, but he doesn't eat out of dumpsters. And then you have Snorkfrøken, that's the female, young Moomin queer character. And then you have Moomin, Moomintrollet, and you have Moomipappa, mommy, Moomin dad, and then you have Moomin mother, Moomin mama, and then you have little me there, just the same as on this cup. I have plenty of Moomin related things. It's not like I'm a huge fan of Moomin, but I do like the design, and they come in different things. Like this is a bowl. And this bowl is with a guy called Sniff, right? And then my girlfriend has these. And here's like a china. It's called Arabia. It's a Finnish brand, I think. So there's like a lot of different products, right? You have here, this one is in use, so I better be careful, but they have all kinds of products. And of course you don't need to know a lot about the characters to enjoy them. My somebody in my family really liked the design, but she was like 60 and she had no like relationship to the characters. She didn't know what they were about. But also there are no perverted things in the characters. I mean, there are like the most child friendly types of character you can have. But she really enjoyed the drawings and the character design. But she had no relationship to the characters. She didn't know like how little me is like a opinionated, strong-willed child, right? She didn't know about that. She just liked the design of it. But you can see it on the design too, can't you? Like she's really a naughty child. Strong-willed, opinionated. So anyway, that was my haul today. Wasn't it great? Didn't you get enriched by it? We talked a little bit about the product. Perhaps shall I look another look? As you can see, it's the same as size relationship. It's smaller. And then these are like they fit very well for a cup of coffee. And I haven't tried it, but I would guess you can take them to if you go on a nature hike, right? You can have this in your back pocket. It can take a little bit of a hit because they are made of metal. Moving on, the point is that I will return with another haul some other time. I've already bought stuff online. I bought something from an online store. Pre-ordered, I think, because it hasn't arrived yet, so either it's pre-ordered or it's lost in the mail because I haven't got it. I can't remember exactly when it was supposed to be arriving, but I've been waiting for it for quite a while. But I think I like did some research why hasn't it arrived, and it turned out I bought it pre-ordered because it wasn't out yet. It was Alien 3. Not the movie. A cartoon edition of the script of one of those alternate scripts. Everybody hates Alien 3. I like it, but everybody hates Alien 3. And then there was like other scripts, and this was one of those other scripts that was supposed to be Alien 3. And I think it's sort of like Alien Colonial Marine or something. I think basically it was basically like Alien Colonial Marine, like, I don't know, I haven't read it, so I'll have a read, and then I'll have a... I'll not get back to you on that one, too. But I usually buy a lot online, and one of the reasons is, of course, because of people like this, you know? Like that guy who eats out of the dumpster. He does that to save the environment, and then I buy more, I eat more meat, just to piss him off, because those people are horrible creatures, and they deserve, they deserve it. When you're more in love with a tree, when you're more in love with nature than you are with other people, there's something horribly wrong with you. And I can tell you, Hitler loved trees more than he did humans. Concentration camps and all those things. But he was a vegetarian, and he wanted Poland to become like this nature reservoir. So he loved nature. Like, so horrible people are environmentally friendly people. You can write that down in your diary. I can just say that. Horrible people love nature, and other people... like, have a respect for nature, don't mind the nature, don't want to desecrate it at all cost. But if you love nature so much that you eat out of dumpsters, you are probably a horrible human being, and that guy is probably like that. So, yeah, I think I'm done. Yeah, I feel I'm done now. It was nice having another hole with you guys. Rate, subscribe, and comment, and remember to eat extra meat so that every vegetarian out there knows it's futile. If you know a vegetarian, you better eat another piece of steak. Or else we're going to go to hell. And why? Because we're going to go into this horrible... environmentally friendly dystopia where everybody has to eat a some horrible food nobody likes. It's not taste anymore. It's all about, you can't eat anything because you enjoy food. You know, you can't eat food because you enjoy it. It just has to be basic necessities to keep on living. Like that would be the dystopian future. Like, if you don't eat this gray paste that gives you all the nutrients you need, the basic nutrients, if you don't eat that and only that, the world is going to end. And it's not going to be meat in there. It's going to be vegetarian or human, you know, Soylent Green is people. It's going to be like that. Yeah. Well, see you around.